Whenever I want to feel the essence of a smooth reggae vibe, but not have to dry clean and Febreze my clothes afterwards, I turn to guitar. So we're just going to do a super quick crash course in reggae music and how you can kind of use a guitar to really get the gist of it. It's going to sound like this. So, it's really, really easy. It's just a few different techniques that we're going to go over in just a couple minutes, rocking the Fender Ultra Strat. As an example here, I'm going to be playing this in the neck position. This is going to be the first thing you might want to think of when you're trying to get like a reggae tone. We're going to do an E minor, right? But instead of an open E minor, we're going to get to that in a second. We're going to play just the highest three strings. In fact, the first kind of groove we're going to do is all going to happen on the G, B, and E string. So I'm just going to bar the 12th fret, which is an E minor voicing. Just like open, right? Like this. And I'm gonna upstroke with a pick, or if you're playing with your fingers, upstroke. It's important. We're not gonna play the downbeat, we're gonna play the and beat on an upstroke. What that means is, instead of going one, two, three, four, we're gonna go one, and two, and three, and four, and. It's on the backbeat. It's a very important kind of sound of the vibe that you're going for, right? Now, a lot of times it can be really hard just playing on the backbeat in space, without like a drummer or something like that. Like a one, and two, and three, and four, and. So one thing that you can do to kind of help yourself keep that downbeat steady vibe is maybe hitting like a one, and two, and three, and four, and. I'm just getting a muted downstroke. Again, the whole thing is I'm just using my pointer finger to bar that 12th fret. One, and, okay? Now you'll notice I'm also not sustaining that. It's not one, and two, and three, and four, and. It's not getting sustained. I'm choking it with the pressure of my pointer finger pretty much right after that upstroke. One, and. Right? You don't hear a lot of it, okay? All I'm going through right now is an Empress compressor pedal with a little bit of reverb on the Fender 65 reissue. So this is what it sounds like. One, and, two, and. Now, some purists may want me to get in the bridge position. Which maybe if you're in a band, that's what you're going for. I just think solo guitar. I always like it in the neck, specifically with the Ultra Strat tone kind of S1 switched on. Now I'm getting all the pickups in this model, right? So, one, and, two, and, three, and, four, and. Anytime you see a minor chord in a progression, just find the root note on the high E string, and then just kind of bar those top three strings. One, and, two, and, three, and. We can go to A minor, fifth fret. Okay, but that's kind of the vibe that we're going for. Now, if you want to get super reggae, do the double upstroke. So I'm going down, up, up, up. Okay? So do it in space or do it with that muted downstroke to kind of keep yourself in time until you can just space it out, right? Now, the only other voicing we really need is a major voicing to pair in case you ever see a major chord in a progression, which I'm sure you will in pretty much every song. So again, we're starting on the 12th fret. Now we're gonna move this all the way back to the 8th fret, and your middle finger is gonna settle right here, kind of on this fret dot on the 9th fret G string. This is gonna be a major chord voicing, where your root note is right here. The C is the 8th fret on the high E string, right? In case you don't know any of the names and chord voicings, I go over all this in my Complete Fretboard Mastery Masterclass, which is on sale. If you want to click the link, the first 100 people get a super discount on that. But yeah, basically we're just going to take that same chord voicing, but we're adding a major third right here. Okay, so 8, 8, 9 from the top up. We're going from 12, 12, 12 to 8, 8, 9. This is just E minor to C. Go back and forth between that. It really sounds cool. If you can get that slide in between them, right? But first we're gonna add a few more chords right here. Really common one is E minor to C to G. G, third fret on the high string is G, that same thing. That slide right here from 3 to 10, the 10th fret on the high string is a D, from G to D major. It's a great way to kind of get that cool sound and slide into it. E minor. C. G. D. Okay? Now, you can kind of get the same vibe if you want to do something, maybe even an acoustic guitar or something that's just like a solo thing to accompany your vocal to get the same vibe, but using fuller open chords with the exact same progression. E minor, C, G, major, D. Okay, so now we could just do the exact same thing where it's like, I'm kind of getting that muted downstroke. I kind of think it sounds good if you have maybe the root note a little bit muted as part of the downstroke in a solo accompany type way, like a one. I'm getting a little bit of tone, you can tell in that downstroke. So it's not totally just like a muted, a dead mute, it's a toneful. Never seen this D major chord? This is a great one to use in solo accompaniment right here. Specifically, all it is to see two frets higher, okay? Specifically in this progression, which you'll see this progression a lot of times, or at least some kind of juxtaposition of these chords in a progression in a key like this. One way I really like to play this is E minor to C. You can keep this same C shape, but make it a G bar chord. Doesn't have to be a bar chord, just the middle. And from the middle, G, again, so right now I've got my ring finger 5A, pinky 5D, middle finger 4G, pointer 3B, which again is kind of indicative of, there's that one we started with, but again, G major bar chord, thinking of the third fret, but not really barring it. That's kind of how I'm seeing that. And then now if you just take this and take everything but your pointer finger and move it up a string, that gets us into that C kind of shape, but on a D. Always sounds good in this key. E minor, C, G, D. Again, just a quick crash course in some kind of reggae style vibe guitar playing that is excellent to practice your rhythm, specifically feeling that backbeat, that upstroke on the and of one, the and of two, the and of three, the and of four, so on and so forth, right? So definitely let me know what you think. I'm going to link you to this, really, I'm loving this Strat in the description. And also, like I said, the masterclass for the first 100 people who check it out. If you have any questions or comments, hit me in the comment section, Instagram, Twitter, or the website. I'll talk to you all soon. Thanks a lot.